The most anticipated Roblox event in the last several years has concluded, and there's a whole lot to say about it. Some people thought the Classic was going to be the greatest event ever, but what we got was far from that. It was most definitely an improvement over the Hunt, but that's really not saying much considering how bad that was. So today, let's go over a few of the biggest pros and cons of the Classic and how Roblox can improve for next time. I'm going to go over this issue first because it affected a ton of people, including myself. The Classic was a thing for a measly 5 days, making it one of the shortest events and possibly the shortest game-centric event ever. A 5-day long event is something that's definitely possible, but only with a format like those 3-game dev events from 2015, not something as big as the Classic. This event was way too big and noteworthy to only be 5 days long, especially given what's going on right now. First of all, it was Memorial Day weekend in the States, so you've got tons of people doing stuff outside of sitting at home and playing games. Secondly, it was and still is exam time for a ton of people, so of course the majority of them are going to prioritize school over Roblox, and then you've got everyone else who was just too busy over a 5-day span for whatever reasons to be able to play. The event was simple enough to complete in 5 days, so that wasn't an issue, but those 5 days happened to be during a super busy time of the year for a lot of people. At first, I thought maybe Roblox made it so short because the older events were only a few days long, but even 15 plus year old ones were 2 weeks, so I don't know. For something as big and special as this, I think 2 weeks is an appropriate time, as that's long enough for almost everyone to play it a bit. The lobby was probably the best part of the Classic and was a huge improvement over the lackluster The Hunt lobby. It looked absolutely amazing, featured its own original quests, and had a lot of other fun stuff like the rocket launchers. I think we can all agree that the lobby was made right and that similar events in the future should have hubs with the same quality. There isn't much else to improve on here as it was close to perfect from what I've seen, so hopefully future hubs are as good too. The prizes are a mixed bag because some people love the Classic look while others rather see more modern and consistent styles. I personally thought the prizes were mostly incredible, especially the updated skater because that series is a bit special to me as some of y'all may know. From what I've seen, the majority of people do like them as well as the effects, prices, and level of difficulty associated with them. Ideally, nothing would cost money, but Roblox has to make some money here, so it makes sense, and thankfully they're nowhere near as expensive as in The Hunt. They were relatively affordable and much nicer than the previous batch, aside from that random layered clothing because that thing sucked. You didn't need to grind for hours across nearly 100 games to get all of them either, with some being obtainable through the hub. I think everything about the prizes, including the style, prices, and difficulty, was better, with maybe my only complaint being that there should be more of them. Unfortunately, Roblox didn't seem to listen to feedback on The Hunt and delivered another dev hunt because supposedly that's what we love. As it usually is with these kinds of events, the participating games and their quests weren't exactly well received for a plethora of reasons. I won't get into specific issues because there are so many and everyone has their own opinions on each quest, but we all know dev hunts cause this problem. Y'all can comment below on your issues with the quest, but just be prepared for people to probably disagree. What I think we can all agree on though is the games Roblox chose being weird because none of them fit the overall theme of the event. The Classic was obviously supposed to be themed around older Roblox, yet none of the games participating were around back then. The oldest game was made in 2015, while well over half of the rest were made in the last 5 years. Roblox didn't choose any Classic games despite there being several active ones, like Natural Disaster Survival, Work at a Pizza Place, and Base Wars. Not having Classic games in a Classic event really took away from the old school's theme, which I honestly feel was worse than the quest being weak. One thing Roblox did improve on is the amount of games and not needing to visit every one to get all the prizes. The Hunt was painful because you needed to play 95 games to get all the prizes, whereas with this one you only needed to play a few. Roblox did give us less games that we didn't have to play, but ideally we wouldn't be having a dev hunt because we always get the same problems. The best case scenario would be Roblox hosting an event in a single original game like the old egg hunts. The Classic's boss battle might have been the most underwhelming thing since Star Wars Episode 7, 8, and 9. Now, I know some people thought the battle itself was trash, but it was actually very much like old NPC PvP games where they just chase you. Definitely not everyone's cup of tea, but there's a reason why it was so simple. The main issue with it has to be the reward you got when beating 1x1x1, because there wasn't one. All of the building up towards this Tix machine opening some grand thing, and all you got is a quick boss battle that rewards you with a credits screen. You don't get any bonus accessory or even a badge which would have allowed you to get an accessory retroactively. This has to be the most disappointing boss battle in the history of events because of its simplicity, which makes sense, and no reward, which doesn't. I don't understand how they couldn't even give a badge for defeating 1x1x1, but somehow they decided not to, so everyone got nothing. A prize should have been obvious, but there was nothing, so next time, Roblox has to add something to reward players for beating the boss. Overall, I think the Classic was way better than the Hunt, but that's not saying much since the Hunt was one of the worst events ever. I feel like the Classic was just alright, and that seems to be the main consensus, that the event was just okay. Despite the improvements though, the ratings for the Classic from 50,000 votes are actually worse than that of the Hunt, and I think I know why. While the Classic was a much better event, I think it was way more disappointing, especially after all the hype leading up to it. It was the first time in years Roblox truly acknowledged their past after seemingly trying to hide it, yet they didn't exactly do it properly. The lack of classic games and the usage of neo-classic avatars Roblox uses to avoid having to use blocky avatars felt pretty disingenuous. There were some amazing parts like the lobby, and the prizes were great. Then there were things like the games and the boss battle that sucked. The 5-day duration of the event was also just terrible because it shut off so many people from playing, including me for most of it. Minor details like no boss battle prize and the short time frame had such a negative effect on the event despite being easily avoidable. The everlasting dev hunt issues is a different story, but a lot of problems boiled down to simple things that could have made it a lot better. This might have been the most anticipated event ever, but it ended up just being an average event with really nothing special about it other than a cool theme. In a perfect world, we have an event that takes place in a single original game with good quests, prizes, maps, etc. that lasts around 2 weeks. I don't know if we're ever going to get something like that though, because Roblox seems so hooked to dev hunts that they ignore feedback about them. Who knows what they'll do next, but what I can say is that I think they're moving in the right direction. The Classic may have been just okay, but it saw significant improvements over the Hunt without taking into consideration the beloved classic Roblox theme. There are still areas Roblox needs to improve upon, but I have more hope for whatever comes next thanks to the Classic. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to like and subscribe and comment and all that YouTube stuff down below.